It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Thursday, July 8th, 2021. Number one, in one of the largest groups of political candidates in one of the most complex forms of voting, Eric Adams has emerged as the winner of the Democratic primary in the race for mayor of New York City. More than 2 weeks after voters cast their ballots in a first-of-its-kind ranked choice election, the Democratic primary appears to be over. The November general election against Republican nominee Curtis Sliwa is regarded as a formality in the heavily Democratic-leaning city. If the former police captain wins the November election, he will be the second black mayor of New York City. Number two, progressive community activist Attica Scott has announced she's running for the U.S. Congress. A win for Scott will mark the first time the state sends a black lawmaker to Congress. Scott has been a visible leader in the state's activist response to the March 2020 death of Breonna Taylor, a 26-year-old black woman killed by police officers in Louisville. In August, Scott proposed Breonna's Law, which bans police from using no-knock search warrants. Number three, the Delta variant is now the dominant strain of COVID in the U.S. According to estimates released by the CDC, 52% of new cases for the two-week period ending July 3rd were linked to the more transmissible strain. Some areas of the country, including the hotspots of Kansas, Missouri, and Nebraska, are currently overwhelmed with COVID-19 cases linked to the Delta variant. Number four. Portland Trail Blazers Carmelo Anthony stands tall as the inaugural winner of the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar Social Justice Award. The new annual honor was created to recognize a player for pursuit of social justice and upholding the NBA's values of equality, respect, and inclusion. Read more about the NBA's social justice activists following in the footsteps of Captain Kareem in today's What You Need to Know newsletter. Number five. Following January 6, in which members of Congress sought to overturn the Electoral College vote, major corporations promised to support the fight for democracy. Dozens of big companies, including Walmart, Pfizer, Intel, General Electric, and AT&T, pledged to avoid donating money to the 147 lawmakers who objected to Congress certification of Joe Biden's victory. 6 months later, many of those companies have resumed funneling cash to political action committees that benefit the election efforts of lawmakers, whether they objected to the election certification or not. Here's your daily inspiration from Yogi's Jewels. If you are truthful and honest with yourself, it doesn't matter what others think or say. All right. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with comedian extraordinaire George Wallace and radio show host extraordinaire Darlene McCoy as we discuss today's top headlines and more. Thank you to our What You Need to Know partner, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. To subscribe to my free daily newsletter, please visit SybilWilkes.com. Be informed, be empowered.